Hello my dear students, welcome to our channel MS2 Physics, where physics gets charged. So in the today's video, we'll discuss the new chapter of work, energy and power from 11th standard. So in this, we'll discuss about the work and its various application of work, and then go for energy, and we are interrelating work and energy, and then we are going for power here, right? So of this, at first, I'll discuss about the work done. So basically, when you are taking any particle or any body, you may take, okay, of mass m, on this when you are acting some external force of F, so that because of this acting force, it undergoes a displacement through the distance S, then work is said to be done by this force on this body, and that work done can be defined as the product of force and displacement. Force and displacement here means you can write W is equals to F and S. So as here, this force is a vector quantity F bar, and displacement is also a vector quantity, so that we can also be define this work done in vector form. So in vector form, we can write W is equals to F bar dot S bar. Sir, how can you say that you are taking only the dot product? Why you are not taking cross product here? So for this, the dot product of two vectors is a scalar quantity, and the cross product of two vectors is a vector quantity. This we are discussed in the previous chapter of vectors. So here, as force and displacement are vector, if you are taking the cross product of these two, the resultant should be a vector. But here, this work done is a scalar quantity. So that here it is not possible to take the cross product, as this is a scalar quantity. So this work done is because of the two physical quantity of force and displacement. Those two are vectors. So by taking the dot product of two vectors is a scalar. So we can define W is equals to F bar dot S bar, right? So that here we can write W is equals to A bar dot B bar is equals to, we know, magnitude of A and magnitude of B into cos of the angle between them. So that F is cos theta. So this F is cos theta, we can write as W is equals to, either you may write F into S cos theta, or you may also write F cos theta into S. Of course, the mathematically both will lead to the same result, but coming to the significance of these vectors, so here there is some difference between these two equations. So here it is supposed to be a horizontal surface. On this, we are acting the force on this particle at an angle theta to the direction of this straight line, so that if the body undergoes a displacement S, then if we are taking the normal drawn onto the displacement from the vector of force, so that here it gives F cos theta into S, or from this only, if we are taking again the force here F bar, and the displacement is along the horizontal direction at an angle theta to the force. So now when you are taking drawn a normal onto the force from this displacement vector, so that here it gives S cos theta. Means here the work done standardly defined as the product of the component of force in the direction of displacement, or the product of force and the component of displacement in the direction of force can be defined as work done. This is what said to be the magnitude of force into the component of displacement. And here it is the product of magnitude of component of force and the magnitude of displacement. Means we can write here W is equals to magnitude of force into the component of displacement, the component of displacement along F bar. Along F bar is according to the expression F is equals F into S cos theta is a W. So now the same, if you want to take the help of this F cos theta into S, It can be defined as the component of force along S bar into the magnitude of displacement. The magnitude of displacement can be defined as the work done here, right? So this is already we have discussed this application in a vectors. Once you go through that video there, right? So now here, when coming to the W is equal to Fs, is the basically the product of force and displacement is the work done, and work done is a scalar quantity. And based on this expression, now can I coming to the units of this work done? When I coming to the SI units here, force, the units of force are Newton, and the units of displacements are meter. Newton meter are the units of work done, and standardly this Newton meter is said to be joule. Means standardly in a SI units are joule. 1 joule is equals to Newton meter. And coming to the CGS units here, the CGS units are erg, or you may write this as dyne centimeter. So when coming to the problems here, we can relating joule and erg as 1 joule is equals to 10 to the power of 7 erg. 1 joule is equals to 10 to the power of 7 erg, or 1 erg is equals to 10 to the power of minus 7 joule. Okay, so the amount of work done by the application of external force on the body is W is equals to, as we have, Fs cos theta, which means this work done will depends on the magnitude of force and the magnitude of displacement and the angle at which we are exerting the force on the body with respect to the direction of motion. Based on these three factors, this work done will depends. And again, the second thing is this work done with respect to the force acting on the body at an angle to the direction of motion, that work done may be said to be zero or positive or negative. How it is, we will discuss now. So here, as we got W is equal to Fs cos theta, so I am taking the condition if theta is less than 90 degrees or greater than or equals to 0 degrees, then work done is a positive. Work done is positive. If I am taking a theta is less than or equals to 180 degrees or greater than 90 degrees, then work done is negative. And here if you are taking a theta is equals to 90 degrees, then the work done is zero. Means this work done, as it is a scalar quantity, as it may be of positive value you may get, or negative value, or zero, that will depends on the action of force with respect to the direction of motion, either in the direction or opposite to the direction or at certain angle or right angles, this work done is varies, right? Means here zero or greater than zero to 90 degrees. So cos is a positive. Up to 90, cos is a positive, so that get positive value according to basics of mathematics. When coming to theta greater than 90 and less than 180 degrees, it is in the second quadrant. When it is the second quadrant, all silver, sign is a positive, cos is a negative, so we will get negative work done. When theta 90, cos 90 is 0, work done is 0. Okay, mathematically it is fine that when theta is varies, then work done is positive or negative or 0. But my point is, when coming to the physical significance of this positive, negative and 0, when do we can take this, sir? So for that, I am coming to one best example is that, let I am taking a body is moves on a rough horizontal surface, means when it has certain coefficient of friction, means it is a rough surface only, and here I am acting the force on this body horizontally towards rightward. Okay, horizontally towards rightward, so that here the force is acting on it. As it moves in forward direction, the frictional force will be acting on it in a backward direction, and here as it is in contact with the ground, the weight of the body is acting vertically downwards, and the normal reaction is upwards. These are the forces which are acting on the body, right? So now if we are taking the work done by external force F, So because of this, the body get displacing in the forward direction only, supposed to be. Then work done is equals to F into S, which is a positive because of theta is a 0 degrees. Theta is a 0 degrees. So work done is a positive here. So now in this concept only, work done by frictional force. Work done by frictional force. So that here the body is moving in the forward direction and the frictional force in upward direction, so that we can write F cos 180 degrees. Cos 180 is a minus 1. So work done by the frictional force is a negative. Work done by the frictional force is a negative here. And again, coming to the work done by the normal reaction are said to be normal force. So W is equals to N S. Here if you are observing the diagram, the normal reaction and the displacements are right angles to each other, theta 90. So there is no work done by the normal reaction. All the three cases I am discussed within a one example here. And now in this only, if they are asking work done by the net force, work done by the net force, what is the net force on this body? Now the net force on this body is the external force F, which is acting in the forward direction, and opposite to the direction of motion there is a frictional force acts on it, so that the net force will become F minus F, of course, into the displacement is S, by equals to W. And here definitely the net force is in the direction of displacement. Definitely this work done is a positive, means with respect to the direction of force and the direction of displacement, this work done may be of positive or negative or zero here. And especially when coming to here, when the work done is a zero, when a force is perpendicular to the direction of displacement, not only this case, we may take the some more cases there. So if I am taking the pendulum here, if I am taking the pendulum, and when this pendulum get oscillates about its mean position, so that work done by the tension in the string on this pendulum is zero. Work done by tension in the string is zero. Why? Because the displacement and the tension always right angles to each other. Or we may take another example here. Whenever you are taking a body is moves in the circular path, or said to be circular motion with a center O, everywhere to the direction of motion and the direction of force, which is said to be centripetal force, which causes the body set into rotation, this work done by the centripetal force is always zero only. Work done by the centripetal force on the particle in the uniform circular motion is always zero. Why? Because here force and displacements are perpendicular, here tension and the displacements are perpendicular, here in this example normal reaction and the force is also be perpendicular here. Right, by this we can classifying this work done may either it is a positive or negative or zero. Or you may take the work done is also be zero if F is zero. Work done is also be zero if displacement is zero. Means if we are not acting any force, if you are not acting any force, the body get displaces, then work done by there is no external force, so the work done is zero here. If the body get if we are acting the force and body not get displaces, like I am acting the force on this wall, does this wall get displaces here? Yes, I am trying to push the wall here, but does it get displaces? No. Even though the external force is here now during the application of the force on this wall, but displacement is not there, so work done by this force is zero. Means it is not necessary to do the work by any external force on the body, okay, when we are acting some force. So after application of a force on the body, if the body get displaces, so that only the work is said to be done by that force there. Got my point here? These are the some applications here about the models of force, work done. And here now discussing the work done by the constant force only. If I am taking a work done on the body from one place to another place during the displacement S, F1, the force is changes from F1 to F2. For the body, a constant, this is a F1, F2 are constant force only, but during the motion of the body from A to B, the force is changes from F1 to F2 at constant rate only.
constantly just under the application of this F1 and F2. Then how we could take this work done, sir? W is equals to, as for the displacement of S, the course of motion, the force is varying from F1 to F2 only, so that, and it is a uniformly changes, so that F1 plus F2 by 2 is the average force experienced by that body, into under the influence of this external force the body get displaces S, so that this is the expression for work done here. Understood? So now here, if the forces varies continuously, sir, then it is not possible to apply this or this basic equation of Fs. So for that we need to use the integral model that we'll discuss in the next video. This is what the work done by the constant force only, but changes F1 to F2 during the course of motion for a displacement, yes. If it is continuously changes, it is not valid. That is what we are taking this work done by a non, what is called a variable force, that we will discuss furtherly. These are the cases of work done when positive, negative or zero here. Thank you, students. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, do like, share, comment and subscribe my channel to get my latest videos.